I am Santosh Galinkar. Today we are solving about the control engine drawing. This is the construction of a root locus for a system with an open loop transverse function. This is the problem they are given. G of s into h of s is equal to k into s plus 6 divided by s into s plus 4. Now number of poles, these indicate poles. Poles. This is nothing but zeros. Zeros. Now number of poles here, 3. P is equal to 3. S is equal to 0 minus 4. Next, number of zeros, z is equal to 1 and s is equal to minus 6. That means you have to take in this way. If it is plus 6 is equal to 0, s is nothing but minus 6. Similarly here, number of branches, here p is greater than z, therefore p is equal to n. N is nothing but 3. Sorry. Number of poles will be 2 here, 0 and 4, 2 poles, okay, everything will be same. P is greater than Z, therefore P will be is equal to N is equal to 2. Number of branches terminating at infinity will be P is nothing but 2 minus 1, Z is 1. Root locus is symmetric about the real axis, root locus is present on the real axis. Angle of asymptotes, this is the angle of asymptotes, this is a formula. Where p is nothing but what? 2 minus 1 minus 1, 0. That means k is equal to 0. Substitute theta 0, 2 into 0 plus 1 into 180 divided by 2 minus 1 is nothing but 180 degree. Angle of asymptotes. Centroid is nothing but sum is nothing but 0 minus 4 minus minus 6 divided by 2 minus 1. If you calculate, it will be plus 2. Centroid will be plus 2. Now breakaway point is nothing but 1 g of s into h of s is equal to 0. Now plus is equal to, write this expression here, g of s into h of s is nothing but this part. Substitute here, it will be k s plus 6 divided by s plus 4 is equal to 0. This can be written as further s plus 4 plus k s plus 6 is equal to 0. Further, it can be simplified in this way, s square plus 4s plus k s plus 6 is equal to 0. Next, s square plus 4 plus k s plus 6k is equal to 0. Next, we are finding the k terms. We are finding the k term here. K will be what here? Now I will consider this part here for finding the k value. I am writing this part again here. K is equal to minus s square plus s4 divided by s plus 6 s plus 3. Now dk by ds is equal to 0. Now I differentiated here. This can be written as further, first considering this term, it will be kept as it is, and this will be differentiated, 2s plus 4. Next, this sum will be as it is. Here neglecting the minus sign, s square plus 4s, differentiation of s is nothing but 1 and constant is 0, divided by s plus 6 whole square is equal to 0. Transfer here, it becomes 0 and it can be written as what? It can be written as 2s square plus 4s plus 12s plus 24 minus s square minus 4s is equal to 0. This and this, it becomes s square. This one and this one, it becomes plus 12s. That means this and this cancel, 12s plus 24 is equal to 0. If you find the root, it will be s is equal to minus 2.53 comma minus 9.46, approximately minus 9.5. Next, you have to find out the crossover point of the root locus with the imaginary axis. With the help of RH criteria, we can find out. For this one, you have to take this value. This value you have to take. You write here s square plus 4 plus k s plus 6k is equal to 0. S square, s1, s0. S is 1, 4 plus k, this will be 6k, this is 0. Cross multiply here, 4 plus k, 6k, 0 divided by 4 plus k. This and this cancel, this will be 6k. Now find out k term. 4 plus k is greater than or equal to 0, therefore k is nothing but minus 4. If k is negative, root locus plot will not intersect the imaginary axis. This is the important point. If k is negative, the plot will never intersect with the imaginary axis. Okay. Next, we are drawing the graph. This is the graph. Imaginary axis, real axis. Don't go for naming of imaginary axis because k is negative. If k is negative, no need to go for k. It doesn't intersect. There should be no cutting over the imaginary axis. Write the number of poles. Number of poles here will be 0. It will be 0. 0. Next is minus 4. And number of zeros, 6 minus 6. This is 6. It should be a circle. Now, count it here in this way. There is only one pole. Therefore, you can draw the root locus from here. Next, count it here. There are two poles, even number poles. Therefore, no root locus here. Now, if we just assume it, there is one more pole or zeros, then here you can draw the root locus. Now, because k is negative, there is no intersection here. Now, find out the roots. Next, centroid. Centroid is plus 2. Centroid lies here. Sigma is equal to plus 2. What about angle? Angle is 180. This edge. 180 degree. Roots. If you think about the root, there are two roots. Minus 2.53. Minus 2.53 is approximately here. Here. Next is about 9.5. 9.5 is here. Both are in the root locus. Now draw a circle here. You have to draw a circle. This way you have to draw it. Now, if there is root located in between the two poles, the arrow should be in this way. Now, there is a circle, zero. There is a zero here. Therefore, away from this point. It should be away from this point. This completes your graph. I am Santosh Gadankar. Thank you very much.